For decades now, the norm in the church has been for the reception of Holy Communion to be in the hand. What if it were the case that this type of reception has been a massive deception? In this 13-part series, Sleight of Hand, Reception Deception, Michael Voris will help you to understand the lies and manipulations that have led many in the church to practice. Sign up for your premium account today to get the in-depth details so you can help the church militant bring this reception deception into the light.
Hello, I'm Michael Miller.
And I'm Rebecca Hasenauer.
Here are latest headlines from churchmilitant.tv news. Earlier today, Pope Francis asked for forgiveness from those sexually abused by priests and vowed that there will be no going back in the church's fight to protect children. The unprepared remarks came while addressing the International Catholic Child Bureau, a Catholic network of organizations in France that protects children's rights. Our Holy Father said, quote, "The church is aware of this damage. We don't want to take a step back in dealing with this problem and the sanctions that must be imposed. On the contrary, I think we must be even stronger. You don't play around with the lives of children," end quote.
Presidents of the Islamic Society, the Catholic Society, and the Pro-Life Society from Cardiff University in the UK attended a student senate meeting to contest a motion that would require the student union to, quote, "prevent affiliated societies and groups from taking part in anti-choice protests or rallies," end quote. Following a 3.5-hour debate, a vote was held showing a majority in support of the motion. A secret ballot followed to reach the final decision. However, the votes were not released due to procedural rules, calling the vote void and rescheduled. Students for Life learned about the vote only 3 days before it was due to take place. Neil Addison, a barrister who specializes in religious freedom, said, quote, "If the student union proceeds with this, then the union and the university could and should be taken to court and an injunction applied for," end quote.
The Bishops' Conference of England and Wales has informed Catholic members of Parliament, or MPs as they're known, that they won't be denied Holy Communion if they voted for same-sex so-called marriage. The statement comes after the Bishop of Portsmouth stated that such politicians should be denied the Holy Eucharist, arguing that it's not a punishment but an act of mercy that might bring them back into communion with the Church. 47 out of at least 82 Catholic MPs voted for the marriage bill for same-sex couples when it passed last year.
The grassroots effort in collecting money to fund the production of a movie based on serial killer abortionist Kermit Gosnell has reached $500,000 with the help of over 7,000 contributors. Founder and director Philippe McAleer has said, quote, "Hollywood and the mainstream media should pay attention. People are angry with them for ignoring the news and the truth. This $500,000 is a strong statement. The people won't wait for Hollywood or the mainstream media. They're fighting back. It's beautiful," end quote.
I'm Michael Miller.
And I'm Rebecca Hasenauer. Those are your headlines from churchmilitant.tv.
Make sure you check out today's Vortex, where Michael talks about Pope Francis's recent homily on closed minds.
Thanks for tuning in today. Spread the word about us to your friends.
Have a great weekend, and may God bless you.
Hi there, churchmilitant.tv supporters. I'm Michael Voris.
And I'm Rebecca Hasenauer.
If you or someone you know is looking to sell or buy a home or a commercial property anywhere in the world, there's an amazing organization called Real Estate for Life that you should definitely check out.
Real Estate for Life generously donates an average of $1,000 to churchmilitant.tv every time a home sale closes.
It's a great way to support us here at CMTV. And don't forget, this comes at absolutely no cost to you.
So please call or email Real Estate for Life today. All the information you need is in the description box.
Michael Voris, along with Rebecca Hasenauer for churchmilitant.tv. God love you.